Hello friends, in the last video we have seen classification of pile based on the load transfer. In the present video we will see how the piles are classified based on the purpose. Classification of pile based on use or purpose, it's up to your wish. So from this classification we may get the one more question from the GATE exam. So you just simply have to by heart these classifications. So first one will be compaction pile. Compaction piles. So if you understand it, what is it mean? Compaction. What is mean by compaction? The soil will get compacted. That means it will get denser. Suppose if you are having any loose soil, there is any loose sand. If you drive the piles, then because of the driving of piles, the surrounding soils will get compacted. So that's why this is used for the loose sands only. The name, it's from the name you can understand, if it is a compaction pile, used for the loose sands and used for the compacting of surrounding soils. So next one will be tension piles. These piles used to resist the upload loads. To resist the uplift loads. So where it is used and what may be the type of their arrangement and all, in the exam they will not ask you. As of now, just remember, if it is a tension pile, just remember that it is used to resist the uplift loads. Next one, third, anchor piles. So anchor piles, that means nothing but to anchor sheet piles, used for the sheet piles, let us remember. To anchor sheet piles. Our sheet pile is nothing but if you want to retain soil weight different levels, then we will use the sheet pile. So to make the stability of the sheet pile, we will anchor the sheet pile. So that's what it is called, the anchor sheet pile. Next one is batten pile, or we can say it is a batter pile. This is used for the to resist the lateral loads. Wherever the lateral loads are acting, there we have to use the batter piles. So in general, these will be in inclined nature. So if you keep the pile inclined only, then the pile will get the capacity to resist the lateral loading. That's why wherever you want to resist the lateral loading, we will keep the pile in inclined way. So those piles are called the batter pile. Next, fender pile. A fender pile, suppose, let us say, for this understanding, let us say if you have gone through the harbor and whatever they'll construct, up to some level, they will construct some retained structures like this for the walkable or for the transfer of goods. So if ships are coming, then we will not allow the ships unto complete level, right? We will allow up to the some distance. After up to that, we will make some supporting structures to transfer the goods. So if your ship is placed here, then because of the waving nature, waves of the sea, this ship may try to hit the structure of the structure. So to avoid that, we will use some piles here. So if you are using some piles here, even if ship has moved, it will touch this fender pile only. So this pile is used to protect concrete deck to from impact which may cause by waves generated by the ships. Okay, so let me write down the definition here. Normally used to protect the concrete deck. Used to protect the concrete deck front structures. What is mean by front structures? These are the exposed to the sea level from impact, which may be caused by the waves generated by ships. That means, so for the transfer of goods, we will construct some concrete decks here. So based on that, we will transfer the whatever the goods or manpower will transfer through this deck. So as the ship is in the sea level, so what happens because of the waves generated in the sea, this ship will try to impact the concrete deck. So if we keep on trying and impacting, the structure may fail. So to avoid that impact, we will construct a pile just in front of the concrete deck. So that pile is called the fender pile. Hope you understand. And the next one is sheet pile. We have already discussed. Sheet pile is nothing but a to retain the soil, we will use the sheet pile. Thank you.